surface tension. So in the last class we have discussed the compressibility bulk, that is the bulk density or the bulk elasticity. Then the we have discussed the vapor pressure, bulk modulus of elasticity K or bulk density K. Then we have discussed the vapor pressure, then the surface tension. So as we know, vapor pressure is defined as it is that pressure for which the liquid changes from gaseous state to liquid state, liquid state to gaseous state. Okay, vapor pressure is that pressure for which the liquid changes from liquid state to gaseous state. Okay, it is, why it happened? Because of the continuous escape of the liquid molecules. Because of the continuous escape of the molecules, so this pressure is known as the vapor pressure. So vapor pressure of a liquid is that pressure for which the liquid changes from liquid state to gaseous state. Then the compressibility and bulk density, that is the compressibility means what? When liquid mass is applied, external forces, it is compressed. When these external forces are released, then it will regain its original volume. So this property of liquid is known as the compressibility of the liquid. Then the bulk modulus of elasticity K, so it is defined as stress, change in stress, or stress divided by strain, or it is dP by minus dV by V, that is change in volume divided by original volume. That is the change in volume divided by original volume is the strain, dP is the change in pressure. So that is stress. Then this 1 by K is defined as the compressibility. Compressibility. Okay, then next we have discussed about the surface tension. Surface tension is that tension, or it is a tensile force which exerts. Surface tension is a tensile force which is which acts on a surface of the liquid which is in contact with the air. Okay, so which is in contact with the air, that is surface tension is nothing but it is a tensile force which is, surface tension is a tensile force which is acting on the surface of the liquid which is in contact with the air, which is in contact with the air. And we have derived the equation 4 sigma divided by R, sigma is equal to, or pressure intensity is equal to 4 sigma, that is the surface tension divided by diameter of the droplet. Okay, this P is what? P is the pressure inside the droplet, sigma is the surface tension, then D is the diameter of the droplet. And if it is hollow bubble or hollow bubble droplet drop, then this P is equal to 8 sigma divided by D. So these things we have discussed in the extra days class. Then next is capillarity. What is the capillarity? It is that property of the fluid. Okay, because of this capillarity, or because of this property, the liquid in a glass tube, when it is immersed in a water or in a liquid, the liquid may rise or it may fall. Okay, so let us say what is the capillarity. Capillarity is what? The rise or fall of a liquid in a glass tube when it is immersed in the stationary mass of, or stationary liquid so that is that property of the liquid is called capillarity. The liquid inside the fluid may rise or may form. Okay, so may form. This is why this is because of the surface tension property again. Okay, so let us take these two. So let us take a container. Okay, this is filled with a water. This is filled with a water. Water is a liquid. Let us take a glass tube and immerse it in a container. Then the liquid inside the glass tube rises up to some level. So this rise of liquid inside this glass tube, let it be H. Let it be H. Okay. Then this is the meniscus. Okay. Then whatever force you are getting here, it is the tensile force or it is the surface tension. Now, what is the equation for this? The weight of liquid, in the tube for a height of H. Okay, what is the weight of this liquid? It is the weight of this liquid inside the tube is the volume of this tube, multiplied by unit weight of water. So that gives you the weight. Then always this weight, it acts in the downward direction at the CG point. So the weight of liquid which is inside the tube, okay, is equal to what? It is the volume of this tube multiplied by the unit weight of water. So what is the volume of this? Area of this tube multiplied by this height. Okay, so the volume of water in the this volume for a height of H, so area of this tube, that is 5 by 4 d square, and this height H, this gives you the volume. 5 by 4 d square into H, this gives you what? This gives you the volume of water, okay, in this glass tube, okay. So now this W is what? It is the specific weight or unit weight of fluid. Specific weight or unit weight of fluid. And this specific weight equal to mass density rho into g. So when I am substituting this, this is 5 by 4 d square h multiplied by rho into g. Let this is equation 1. And this force, this is the self weight or self weight of liquid which is stored in this tube and it will act in the downward direction. This mass of liquid, when it will equilibrium, when there is a opposite force which is supposed to act in the upward direction. So by which force this mass of liquid which is in the glass tube is under the equilibrium condition? That is because of this vertical component of this sigma. What is the vertical component of this sigma? This is sigma, this is the tensile force or the surface tension multiplied by cos theta. So, and it will act in the upward direction. This is the sigma cos theta. It is vertical component. This is the, then this W is the what? This is the weight of water which is stored in this is 5 by 4 d square h by rho g. Then vertical component of surface tensile force. Okay, vertical component of surface tensile force is equal to what? This is the sigma. Sigma is what? What is the dimension of this? This is Newton per meter. Okay, so when I am multiplying by the circumferential length of the tube, that gives me the force. okay, circumferential length, that is in terms of meter. So this meter cancels, so you are getting sigma in terms of force. So sigma into circumferential length, this gives me the tensile force which acts in the upward direction, and its component is, so sigma into circumferential length, that gives you the tensile force, and its vertical component is, so when I am resolving this in the upward direction, it is cos theta. So this is equation 2. Then this mass of fluid is under the equilibrium condition when this downward force must be equal to upward force. That means what? Weight of liquid in the tube of height h must be equal to vertical component of surface tensile force. Okay, that is equation 1 gives you the weight of liquid inside the glass tube. Equation 2 gives you the vertical component of surface tensile force in the surface tensile force. So that is sigma phi d cos theta. Equating equation 1 and 2, so you are getting 5 by 4 d square h rho g. This is equal to sigma phi d cos theta. Therefore, h is equal to 4 sigma cos theta rho g d. So approximately when the liquid is water in the container, this theta is 0. So cos 0 is equal to 1. So this h is equal to 4 sigma divided by rho g d. Okay, similarly, when the liquid is mercury, then there is a fall of liquid inside the glass tube. There is a fall of liquid inside the glass tube. Okay, this is the fall. This is why, or this is for what? This is because of surface tension property of the fluid. Okay, so the fluid is depressed or it is going to fall, and this fall h is again, it holds good the same equation, h is equal to 4 sigma cos theta rho g d. But for mercury, this theta is taken as 128 degrees. Okay, this ends the discussion on the properties, means 50% of the unit 1, it is completed. So in these 5 classes, so we have discussed the basic principles used in the analysis of fluid mechanics. The basic principles are law of conservation of mass, law of conservation of momentum, law of conservation of energy. Then we have started discussion on the important properties of the fluid, the important property. Then we also discussed the difference between solid, fluid and gas. Okay, so if the molecules are placed very close or in compact form, that is called solid. It relatively with larger space, it is called liquid, and still relatively with larger space between the molecules, it is in the gas. So it is all the form of matter, form of the matter. The matter may be in the form of solid, or it is in the form of liquid, or it is in the form of gas. So this we have discussed in the earlier class. Then we have started discussion on the important properties. The very important property, first property, is the mass density rho, which is ratio of mass divided by volume. Then next we have discussed the unit weight of water, that is the specific weight, which is defined as weight divided by volume. And this is the Newton per meter cube. Then the dimension of rho is kg per meter cube. Then we have discussed the specific volume. Then we have discussed the specific gravity of the fluid. Then we have discussed the compressibility and bulk modulus of elasticity of a fluid. Then we have discussed the vapor pressure. Then we have discussed the surface tension, and we have discussed the capillarity. So these are the basic things, that is the properties. So based on the properties, we have also discussed one important property, that is the viscosity. Okay, viscosity. So we have also discussed the Newton's law of viscosity. So the Newton's law of viscosity, we have derived this equation. Please go through all these things. Mu dv by dy. So this is the shear stress, and this is the dynamic viscosity, and this is the velocity gradient. Okay, the dimension of mu is Newton second per meter square. Okay, that is the this is the tau is equal to mu dv by dy. Mu is what? It is the dynamic viscosity. We have also discussed another property, that is the kinematic viscosity. Please, you go through all these things. Then the next class, we are going to discuss hydrostatics, that is the pressure and variation of pressure in the static mass of fluid. Okay, that is the pressure and pressure measurements. So just I will give you example, a physical problem, physical example, that is okay. Why the study of pressure, variation of pressure, then measurement of pressure required? See, this is just a physical problem. Let us take a physical concept. Suppose if you have a tank. Okay. Suppose if you have a tank, fill it with water. Fill it with water. Okay, fill it with water. Now, I am taking some holes on one side. So one hole at this point and inserting a tube. Okay, inserting a tube or a pipe. And I am taking one more, or I am inserting one more tube here of same length here. I am also inserting another tube of same length. So this tube or this hole is, this is the free surface. This is the free surface of fluid. Okay, this hole is at a depth of h from the free surface. This hole is at a depth h1 from this hole, and this tube is at a depth of h2 from this hole. Okay, now let us allow fluid to flow through them. Let us, you close this, initially you close all these three tubes, and now you open these three tubes. Okay, the liquid mass, the fluid will come out from this container and it drops like this. Okay, it drops like this. Then similarly it drops here like this, and it drops here like this. See, here the fluid, it is going to fall, or it will come out with some force or some pressure, and it falls with a certain distance d, and here it falls with a certain distance d2, and it falls immediately. Okay, why this? This is a physical problem. Okay, you just take any container, you just take three holes at the different elevations, insert some three tubes and observe the flow. Observe the flow, how the liquid will come out from the container in the three tubes which have been placed in the different depths. Okay, the fluid falls at the different, it travels some vertical length, then it falls in the downward direction. Again it falls vertically, horizontally, and it falls. Similarly here also the fluid flows in the horizontal direction and it falls in the vertical direction. So here, but the horizontal distances are not same. This is why, oh, you can think, so this is because of the variation of pressure exerted by this fluid, which is static fluid. Okay, here, so as you have discussed in your PUC classes, you have the potential energy and the kinetic energy. So when this liquid or fluid, when it is stored in this container, it is possessing the potential energy. When I am putting a hole and I am allowing fluid to flow through this pipe, then this potential energy is going to convert kinetic energy and it is coming out. So this is because of the variation of pressure. So next class we will start discussion on the fluid statics or pressure, variation of pressure and measurement of pressure. So next class we will start discussion on the fluid hydrostatics or the, in this we will study the discussion on pressure, variation of pressure, then the measurement of pressure. So this is remaining half of first unit. Okay, so next class you please, I am requesting you to attend next class. It is a very important class and it is a, on that class I am deriving the differential equation to know the variation of pressure. Okay, we will derive the three dimensional pressure variation equation, how the pressure varies in a static mass of fluid. So that is a very, got the very important application, especially from the civil engineering point of view, when you want to design a water tank. You must know how the water pressure is varying or how acting on the supporting planes. So then only it is possible to design the water tank. Similarly, we are using the design of dams, then in the irrigation, to design the so many irrigation structures. So a lot of that has got a lot of practical applications or civil engineering applications. Without missing the next class, that is, in the next class we will derive the three-dimensional differential equation, how pressure varies, or to know the variation of pressure we will, so whatever physical problem we have discussed here, we will put it in a mathematical form, how to calculate that pressure variation. Okay, so what is the pressure at the bottom pipe, what is the pressure at the middle pipe, what is the pressure at the top pipe, so all these things are to be calculated. So this is called the supporting plane. So all these things we will discuss in the next class. So the next class is a very important class. So next Tuesday, so we are going to start the class sharply by 9:10. So I am requesting all of you, please join that class at next coming Tuesday at 9:10. And if you have any questions, still we have not got any questions. In the last class I have told, even you can send the questions in the writing form. So you please, if you have any doubts, any questions, you write and send to us. We will send the answers, or we will reply the answers in the next class. Okay, thank you.